Hello everyone, this is morning devotion. Like God says in Lamentation chapter 3 verse 23 that His compassion never fails, they are new every morning. So that's why we are meeting on this online to hear the devotions. So let's read from Jeremiah chapter 36 verse 27. Now here in the word says, now after the king had burned the scroll with the words which Baruch had written, at the instruction of Jeremiah, the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah saying, take yet another scroll and write on it all the former words that were in the first scroll which Jehoiakim the king of Judah has burned. And verse 32 says, then Jeremiah took another scroll and gave it to Baruch the scribe, the son of Neriah, who wrote on it at the instruction of Jeremiah all the words of the book which Jehoiakim king of Judah had burned in the fire. And beside there were added to them many similar words. Here is the story in Jeremiah where Jehoiakim the king did not like what Jeremiah wrote on the first scroll. Like he said in the verse 29, thus says the Lord, you have burned this scroll, saying, why have you written in it that the king of Babylon will certainly come and destroy this land and cause man and beast to cease from here? Therefore thus says the Lord concerning Jehoiakim the king of Judah, he shall have no one to sit on the throne of David, and his dead body shall be cast out to the heat of the day and the frost of the night. God judged Jehoiakim the king for burning the scroll, first scroll which Jeremiah wrote with the help of Baruch. And still, like here, Jehoiakim did not like what Jeremiah wrote on it, because he was not liking that Babylon will come and destroy the Jerusalem. But here, when Jehoiakim burned the scroll, God said to Jeremiah, rewrite it, take another scroll, write it on it, the former words which was on the first scroll. Sometimes we may say like our hard work is burnt, you know, it's gone. Now what to do? I don't want to struggle anymore. I don't want to. We get discouraged. But Lord comes again and encourage Jeremiah that take another scroll, write everything which was on the first scroll. Isn't it like rewrite it? It's like Jeremiah heard those words. He again took the help of Baruch and wrote the former words which were on the first scroll, and he rewrote it on the second scroll. He was not like discouraged about why Jehoiakim had to burn that scroll, why he did it. But he instead listened to God's voice and he rewrote it on the second scroll, another scroll. That's amazing for our daily life. Like sometimes which something goes, like something we say it's waste, it's gone. But like if you look at the story, one more story in Luke chapter 5, where disciples, like you know, in verse 3, he saw the disciples' boat. Like then he got into one of the boats, which was Simon's, and asked him to put out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the multitudes from the boat. And verse 4 says, when he had stopped speaking, he said to Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a catch. But Simon answered and said to him, Master, we have toiled all night, caught nothing. Nevertheless, at your word, I will let down the net. They heard Christ's word, like, at your word, we going again, I'm going to catch. And amazing thing happened. They saw the miracle. They saw the miracle that God can do it. They toiled previous night, they toiled whole night, nothing happened. Went for a waste, looks like. But at your word, like Simon saying, at your word, we are going again. Like, doing it again. Like Jeremiah, rewriting it again. And in book of Ezra and Nehemiah, rebuilding the wall, rebuilding the city, doing it again. Yes, enemy came down and burned the city in Jerusalem. They had to go to captivity for 70 years. But when they came back, when they returned from the Babylon, from the exile, they rebuilt it, the temple and the walls. So they were not discouraged. Yes, it happened in the past, but let's rebuild it. Now, same thing in Romans chapter 12, remember that Paul is saying that do not be conformed to the world, right? But renewing of the mind. When we read the word, when we read this word daily in the morning, we renewing of the mind so that we can accept the will of God, so that we can really please God through this word, renewing the mind. So this morning devotion would be like, you know, rewrite, rebuild, renew in the word, and see the miracle of God. Like when we launch out into the deep, we'll see the hand of God. Like we'll find God's hand in that miracle. We'll see that God's hand is that. We thank God that we rewrote, we retook, like retake. Like no problem, it happened. Some mistakes happened in the past. But God is gracious to Jeremiah. God is gracious to Ezra, Nehemiah. God is gracious to disciples in New Testament. Like do it again. See, put the net in the on the right side and you'll see the miracle. No problem, you toiled whole night. No problem, the scroll was burnt. The first scroll was burnt. Rewrite it. Take another scroll and see the... And they did it. Right? They did it in the New Testament and the Old Testament. Same with us from present situation. No problem what happening. Something is like burnt. Something is gone. Something is wasted. But do it again. God is saying like, don't be discouraged. That God is with us. Amen. So have a beautiful day. Let's pray. Thank you, Father, for these words. The former words. The ancient words. That builds us up. Renews us. Restores us, Lord. Rebuilds us, Lord. And thank you, Father, that we cannot be discouraged with the past. But always will be renewed because of your word. So bless all those people who are listening to this morning devotion. Guide their ways, Lord. Help them. In Jesus' name I ask. Amen. 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 Thank you.